بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسوله وأصحابه أجمعين. أما بعد, today بإذن الله we begin the 26th sitting, المجلس السادس والعشرون في أسباب الدخول النار. From the causes of entering the hellfire. So بسم الله. So first of all, let's get the So the Sheikh, he begins, Bismillah. Alhamdulillah al-Qawi al-Mateen, al-Zahir al-Qahir al-Mubin. La ya'zibu an sam'ihi aqallu al-anin, wa la yakhfa ala basrihi harakatu al-janin. Dhalla li kibriyaihi jababiratu al-salatin, wa batala amama qudratihi kaydu al-kaidin. قضى قضاؤه كما شاء على خائتين وسبق اختياره من اختياره من العالمين فهؤلاء أهل الشمال وهؤلاء أهل اليمين جرى القدر بذلك قبل عمل العاملين ولولا هذا التقسيم لبطل جحاد المجاهدين وما عرف أهل الإيمان من الكافرين ولا أهل الشك من أهل اليقين ولولا هذا التقسيم امتلأت النار من المجرمين الله mentions ولو شئنا لأعطينا كل نفس خداها ولكن حق القول مني لأملأن جهنم من الجنة والناس أجمعين. So we stop there and we continue, inshallah. So we'll break the introduction down. So the Sheikh, he starts with praising Allah, all praise is due to Allah, the strong, the powerful, the omnipotent, the vanquisher. The slightest whimper is not hidden from Allah, from his hearing, and the movement of the fetus in the womb is not hidden from his sight. The tyrannical rulers humble themselves to his glory, and the conspiring of the plotters is rendered worthless in front of him. In front of his might and power. He made his decision on the sinners as he wills, and his decision to choose whom he wills from amongst the creatures has already preceded. The first ones are the people of the left hand, and the second are the people of the right hand. The destiny has already been written before the deeds of the doers, and had it not been because of this separation, then the efforts of those who strive hard would have been a waste, and there would not have been any difference between the believers and the disbelievers, between those who have certainty and those who are in doubt. Had it not been because of this division, the hellfire would not have been filled up with the criminals. Allah mentions in the ayah that we quoted, and if we had enforced our will, we could have given every soul its appropriate guidance. But the word from me has come true that I will fill hell with jinn and men altogether. That's Surah Sajda. And that's verse 13. So then the Sheikh mentions here, تِلْكَ يَا أَخِي حِكْمَةُ اللَّهِ وَهُوَ أَحْكَمُ الْحَاكِمِينَ أَحْمَدُهُ سُبْحَانَهُ حَمْدَ الشَّاكِرِينَ وَأَسْأَلَهُ مَعُونَةَ الصَّابِرِينَ وَاسْتَجِيرُ بِهِ مِنَ الْعَذَابِ الْمُحِينَ وَأَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ الْمَلِكُ الْحَقُّ الْمُبِينَ وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله المصطفى الأمين صلى الله عليه وعلى صاحبه أبي بكر أول تابع من الرجال على الدين وعلى عمر القوي في أمر الله فلا يلين وعلى عثمان زوج ابنتي الرسول ونعم القرين وعلى علي بحر العلوم العنزعي البطين، وعلى جميع آل بيت الرسول الطاهرين، وعلى سائر أصحابه الطيبين، وعلى أتباعه في دينه إلى يوم الدين، وسلم تسليما. So the Sheikh, he continues with this introduction, and he mentions, oh my brothers, that indeed it is the wisdom of Allah, and he is the most just of judges. I thank him, glorify is he, the thanks of the grateful ones, and I ask him to grant me the support of those who are patient, and I seek his refuge from the humiliating punishment, and I further bear witness that none has the right to be worshipped in truth but Allah alone, the only true King, and I further bear witness that Muhammad is his slave and his chosen messenger, the trustworthy. May the peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, his companion Abu Bakr, the first follower of the religion from amongst the men, and Umar, the one who was strong and firm with the command of Allah, and Uthman, the husband of the two daughters of the Prophet how excellent is his companionship, and upon Ali, the ocean of knowledge, upon and upon all the righteous family members of the Prophet and upon his companions, and upon all of those who follow him in the religion until the day of resurrection. So that was the introduction. So then the Sheikh begins with Ikhwani i'lamu anna lidukhul an-nari asbaban بينها الله في كتابه وعلى لسان رسوله ليحذر الناس منها ويجتنبوها وهذه الأسباب على نوعين النوع الأول أسباب مكفرة تخرج فاعلها من الإيمان إلى الكفر وتوجب له الخلود في النار، والنوع الثاني أسباب مفسقة تخرج فاعلها من العدالة إلى الفسق ويستحق بها دخول النار دون الخلود فيها. So then the Sheikh he mentions, he says, oh my brothers, know that entering the hellfire has many causes, that which Allah has clarified in his book and on the tongue of his messenger, in order that the people will be aware and cautious of them and stay away from them. So these causes have two types. The first type are the causes that actually take a person outside of the fold of Islam into disbelief. And these causes necessitate that if a person commits them and doesn't repent, he will abide in the hellfire forever. So that's the first type. And the second type are causes that make an individual lose the right of being considered just and truthful. Rather, he will be considered a wicked person and a wicked sinner. They make him deserving of being in the hellfire, but without being in there forever. So that's one is forever, disbelief, and one which isn't disbelief, but sin, but it's not forever. So then the Sheikh he mentions فأما النوع الأول فنذكر منه أسبابا. So he said, as for the first type, we will mention the categories from it, which is the first type, which means that they will be in the hellfire forever, the one who disbelieves. So السبب الأول الشرك بالله بأن يجعل لله شريكا في الربوبية أو الألوهية أو الصفات. فمن اعتقد أن مع الله خالقا مشاركا أو منفردا أو اعتقد أن مع الله إلها يستحق أن يعبد أو عبد مع الله غيره فصرف شيئا من أنواع العبادة إليه أو اعتقد أن لأحد من العلم والقدرة والأذمة ونحوها مثل ما لله عز وجل فقد أشرك بالله شركا أكبر واستحق الخلود في النار. قال الله عز وجل إنه من يشرك بالله فقد حرم الله عليه الجنة ومأواه النار وما للظالمين من أنصار. So the Sheikh, he mentions the first type of these people is the one who commit shirk with Allah, associate partners in worship with Allah, and that is by ascribing a partner to Allah in His lordship. Yeah? So in His lordship of Allah creating, Allah sustaining, Allah owning everything, you know, Allah giving life and death, you know, Allah controlling all the affairs, giving a share of that to other than Allah. His right to be in his right to be worshipped, or in his attributes. So if he gives any of these, these are the three categories of Tawheed. So if he gives any right to other than Allah of these, then he's committing shirk. He's made a partner with Allah. Yeah, so whoever believes that there is another creator along with Allah who, you know, is participating with him in the creation, or has his own creation, or the one who believes that there is another, you know, Lord or deity who is worthy of being worshipped besides Allah, or worships other deities along with Allah by directing some of the acts of worship to them, or that one who believes that there is something or someone who has knowledge like that of Allah, or power like Allah's power, or who has knowledge like that of Allah, you know, or other attributes similar to this, such as an individual has, you know, any of the other attributes that he attributes to other than Allah, then he's associated partners with Allah and has committed major shirk. Yeah, and he falls into polytheism, and this person, if he does not make tawbah, doesn't make repent before he dies, he will abide in the hellfire forever. As Allah mentions in the ayah, indeed, whoever associates partners with Allah, the Almighty, Allah will make the paradise forbidden for him, and his abode will be in the hellfire, and for the evil doers, there will be no helpers. That's Surah Al-Ma'idah. Verse 72. So then the Sheikh mentions السبب الثاني الكفر بالله عز وجل أو بملائكته أو كتبه أو رسله واليوم الآخر أو قضاء الله أو وقدره فمن أنكر شيئا من ذلك تكذيبا أو جحدا أو شك فيه فهو كافر مخلد في النار. قال الله تعالى إن الذين يكفرون بالله ورسوله ويريدون أن يفرقوا بين الله ورسله ويقولون نؤمن ببعض ونكفر ببعض ويريدون أن يتخذوا بين ذلك سبيلا أولئك هم الكافرون حقا وأعتدنا للكافرين عذاب محين. So the Sheikh, he mentions another ayah, وقال تعالى إن الله لعن الكافرين وأعد لهم سعيرا خالدين فيها أبدا لا يجدون وليا ولا نصيرا يوم تقلب وجوههم في النار يقولون يا ليتنا أطعنا الله وأطعنا الرسول وقالوا ربنا إنا أطعنا صادتنا وكبرانا فأضلونا السبيل ربنا آتيهم ضعفين من العذاب والعنهم لعنا كبيرا. So here the Sheikh, he mentions the second category are those who disbelieve in Allah Azawajal, or in the angels, or in the Allah's books, or in His messengers, or in the Day of Judgment, or in pre-decree. Yeah. So these are the five pillars. So if he disbelieves in Allah, His angel, so the six pillars of Iman, sorry. So if he disbelieves in any one of these, he's a disbeliever. So whoever denies anything from that, and whoever denies anything from that because of doubt in them or disbelieves in them, then he will be in the hellfire forever if he doesn't repent before he dies. Then he mentions here the Sheikh, the Quran ayah, surely those who disbelieve in Allah and His messengers and seek to make a distinction between Allah and His messengers and say we believe in some and disbelieve in others, and we and seek to take away between them, between the, these really are the disbelievers, and we have prepared for the disbelievers a humiliating punishment. And then Allah mentioned the other ayah that we mentioned, and Allah has surely cursed the disbelievers and has prepared for them a blazing fire wherein they will abide forever. They will find therein no friend, no helper on the day when their faces are turned over into the fire. They will say, oh, would that we had obeyed Allah and obeyed the messenger. And they will say, our Lord, we obeyed our chiefs and our great ones, and they led us astray from the way. Our Lord, give them double punishment and curse them with a mighty curse. So then the Sheikh mentions the th third category. He said, a-sabab al-thalith, the third reason for that was inkar fard shay'un min arkan al-islam al-khamsa. So is to deny an obligation from the five pillars, yeah, from the five pillars of Islam. فمن أنكر فريضة فريضة توحيد الله أو شهادة لرسول رسوله بالرسالة أو عمومها لجميع الناس أو فريضة الصلاة الخمس أو زكاة أو صوم رمضان أو الحج فهو كافر لأنه مكذب لله ورسوله وإجماع المسلمين. وكذلك من أنكر تحريم الشرك أو قتل النفس التي حرم الله أو تحريم الزنا أو اللواط أو الخمر أو نحوها مما تحريمه ظاهر صريح في كتاب الله أو سنة رسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم لأنه مكذب لله ورسوله. لكن إن كان قريب أحد بالإسلام فأنكر ذلك جهلا لم يكفر حتى يعلم فينكر بعد علمه. So here the Sheikh, he mentions the third category is denying the obligation of any of the five pillars that we mentioned. That is, the saying that any of them are not obligation. So whoever denies obligation of the two shahadatain, the two testimonies, one of Islam, that none has a right to be worshipped in truth except Allah alone, and that Muhammad is the messenger of Allah, or denies that it requires to be said by all of mankind, or denies the obligation of the five daily prayers, the obligation of paying the zakat on the fasting of the month of Ramadan, or performing Hajj, or to the Kaaba, to the house of Allah, that individual will be considered a disbeliever because he is denying what Allah and His Messenger have commanded and the consensus of the Muslims. Likewise, whoever denies the impermissibility of shirk or killing someone without due right, or fornication or homosexuality or alcohol or the likes from that, from these things like riba and other than that, then which are clearly impermissible are mentioned in the book of Allah and the Sunnah of the Messenger, then that person's a disbeliever. This is because he is rejecting Allah and His Messenger. However, if he's new to Islam, yeah, if he's new or someone who entered into Islam quite new, and because of his ignorance, he's mentioned that, then that person is taught. But if he rejects that after he's been taught, then he's also a disbeliever as well. So if he's a new person who's new to Islam and is ignorant, then he's taught, But then even if he continues upon that, then he falls into that category as well of denying the five pillars, and he's a disbeliever. As-sabab ar-rabi, the fourth category, al-istihza'u billahi subhanahu wa bi dinihi wa rasulihi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. قال تعالى ولئن سألتهم ليقولن إنما كنا نخوض ونلعب قل أبالله وآياته ورسوله كنتم تستهزئون لا تعتذروا قد كفرتم بعد إيمانكم. So then the Sheikh, he mentions the fourth category is mocking Allah and his religion or his messenger, you know, so then Allah the Most High is mentioned, that, and if you question them, they will surely say, "We were only, you know, joking and talking idly." Say, "Was it Allah and His ayahs and signs and His verses and His messenger that you mocked?" Make no excuse. You have certainly disbelieved after believing. That's Surah Tawbah. Yeah, and that's that's 65 and 64 and 65. So then the Sheikh, he mentions والاستحزاء هو السخرية وهو من أعظم الاستحانة بالله ودينه ورسوله وأعظم الاحتقار والإزدراء تعالى الله عن ذلك علو كبير. So the Sheikh, he mentions mocking is one of the worst ways of degrading Allah, His religion, and His messenger. Is the worst forms of belittling and scorning. Glorified is Allah far above that. So that is mocking any sign or trait of the religion, and a lot of people fall into this, you know, and they are negligent in this. Maybe upon the Jahiliyyah, where they mock the signs of Islam, for example, the beard. Yeah, or the hijab of the woman, you know, and they make disparaging comments. You got to be careful about that. Then the fifth category, as-sabab al-khamis, sabb Allah ta'ala aw deenihi aw rasulihi wa huwa al-qadhu wal-aybu wa dhikruhum bima yaqtadi al-istighfaf wal-intiqasa kal-la'ni وَتَقْبِيهِ وَنَحْوُ ذَلِكَ. So then the Sheikh, he mentions the sixth, fifth category is insulting Allah the Most High, or insulting His religion, His messenger, by defaming and you know, denigrating them, mentioning them with malicious intent in order to attack their reputation, or by way of cursing, distorting, and the likes. Yeah. So that is cursing Allah and the religion or the Prophet, or, you know, showing it in a bad way. So this is one of the ways of disbelief. So then the Sheikh goes, قَالَ شَيْخُ الْإِسْلَامِ ابْنُ تَيْمِيَةَ رَحْمَ اللَّهُ مَنْ سَبَّ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولَهُ فَهُوَ كَافِرٌ ظَاهِرًا وَبَاطِنًا سَوَاءُ كَانَ يَعْتَقِدُ أَنَّ ذَلِكَ مُحَرَّمٌ أَوْ كَانَ مُسْتَحِلًّا له أو كان ذاهلا عن اعتقاد. وقال أصحابنا يكفر سواء كان مازحا أو جادا، وهذا هو صواب المقطوع به. ونقل عن إسحاق بن راهويه أن المسلمين أجمعوا على أن من سب الله أو سب رسوله أو دفع شيئا مما أنزل الله فهو كافر، وإن كان مقرا بما أنزل الله. وقال الشيخ أيضا، والحكم في سب سائر الأنبياء كالحكم في سب نبينا صلى الله عليه وسلم. فمن سب نبيا مسمى باسمه من الأنبياء المعروفين المذكورين في القرآن أو موصوفا بالنبوة بأن يذكر في الحديث عن أن نبيا فعل أو قال كذا، فيسب ذلك الفاعل أو قائل مع علمه أنه نبي فحكمه كما تقدم. So the Sheikh, he mentions now, the Sheikh, Sheikh Islam Ibn Taymiyyah has a speech on this. So he mentioned, Sheikh Islam Ibn Taymiyyah, may Allah have mercy upon him, said, whoever insults Allah and his messenger has become a disbeliever inwardly and outwardly, whether he believes this, that is forbidden for him or not, and whether he is unmindful of the creed or not. Our companion, I mean the scholars of the Hanbali scholar, school of thought, say whoever insults Allah disbelieves, whether he is serious or joking. This is the correct opinion in this subject matter. So this is very important, especially with the rise of some people calling Muslim comedians. And subhanAllah, they do make jokes insulting Allah and the Prophet ﷺ and the religion, whether they intend it indirectly or directly. And we seek Allah's refuge in falling into that. So then he mentioned, it's also reported by Isaac bin Rahawai from the Salaf, that the Muslims have agreed that whoever insults Allah and his messenger or denies anything from the revelation of Allah, he disbelieves even if he believes in what Allah has revealed. Yeah. So yeah. And then likewise, the Sheikh, he said, insulting all the messengers takes the same ruling as insulting our Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Therefore, whoever insults any messenger from among the messengers that are mentioned by name in the Quran or described in the hadith of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam by the actions or statements has disbelieved. Then the Sheikh said, then he goes on to, وَأَمَّا سَبُّ غَيْرَ الْأَنْبِيَاءِ فَإِنْ كَانَ الْغَرْضُ مِنْهُ سَبَّ النَّبِيِّ مِثْلُ أَنْ يسب أصحابه ويقصد به سب النبي لأن المقارن يقتدي بمن قارنه ومثل أن يقذف واحدة من زوجات النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بزنا ونحوه فإنه يكفر لأن ذلك قدح في النبي وسب له قال الله تعالى والخبيثات للخبيثين. So then the Sheikh he continues and he mentions, but as for insulting other than the prophets, other than the prophets, if the intention behind it is to insult the Prophet ﷺ, then it is disbelief, such as insulting the Prophet's companions like the Shia do. Yeah, this is because the companions imitate and follow the Prophet ﷺ. So the same applies to anyone who accuses one of the wives of the Prophet of adultery has disbelief, like the Shias do with our mother of the believers, Aisha, may Allah be pleased with her, radiallahu anha. So they are disbelievers then. That is because insulting them is insulting the Prophet ﷺ. And Allah the Most High said, the evil women are for the evil men. So if they're trying to insult the Aisha, radiallahu anha, then they insulting the Prophet ﷺ, or rather she was pure and she was free from the filthy accusation that they put against her in the Quran itself by Allah. So then the sixth category, so that gives them another indication who hold those beliefs like the Shia. If they hold that belief, then they are kafir. The sixth category is what? As-sabab as-sadis, al-hukmu bi-ghayri ma anzal Allahu mu'taqidan annahu aqrabu ila al-haqqi wa aslahu lil-haq aw annahu musawin li-hukmi Allah aw annahu yajuz al-hukm bihi fa huwa kafirun liqawlihi ta'ala wa man lam yahkum bima anzal Allahu fa ulaika humul kafirun. Surah Al-Ma'idah was 44. وَكَذَا لَوْ اِعْتَقَدَ أَنَّ حُكْمَ غَيْرِ اللَّهِ خَيْرٌ مِّنْ حُكْمِ اللَّهِ أَوْ مُسَاوٍ لَهُ أَوْ أَنَّهُ يَجُوزُ الْحُكْمُ بِهِ فَهُوَ كَافِرٌ وَإِنْ لَمْ يَحْكُمْ بِهِ لِأَنَّهُ مُكَذِّبٌ لِقَوْلِهِ تَعَالَى وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ مِنَ اللَّهِ حُكْمًا لِقَوْمٍ يُوقِنُونَ وَلِمَا يَقْتَدِيهِ قَوْلُهُ وَمَنْ لَمْ يَحْكُمْ بِمَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْكَافِرُونَ. So here the sixth category is judging by other than what Allah has revealed. So this is, for example, people judging by man-made laws instead of the Sharia of Allah, but believing that it is the closest to the truth and that is more beneficial to the people than judging with what Allah has revealed, believing that it is equal to Allah's judgment, or even that it is permissible to judge by. Such individuals have disbelieved based on Allah's ayah. Whoever did not judge by what Allah has revealed are indeed the disbelievers. So if an individual believes that judging by other than what Allah has revealed is better than Allah's judgment, he has disbelieved. This is because he has rejected Allah's statement, who is better than Allah in judgment for a people who have firm faith. And his statement, whoever did not judge by what Allah has revealed, then they are the disbelievers. But a lot of the Khawarij, they misuse this, you know, to attack the Muslim rulers. We need to be careful with this. You know, if the Muslim ruler believes that this is better than the, this is the point, that judging democracy or ruling by whatever, you know, ruling is better than the Sharia, then he's a disbeliever. But if he rules, but he knows that the Sharia is better, but he's doing it because he's forced, or he thinks that, you know, that's the way he's going to get elected or whatever, then that's kufr duna kufr. And that's got a different ruling. You know, that's got a different ruling. And that's a person's a sinner, but he's not a kafir. Yeah. But if he believes that, no, the Sharia is backwards, we need democracy, and he says that and he believes that, then he's a kafir. Yeah. So that's the important distinction that you need to make. And all the Khawarij don't make that. The likes of ISIS and those who follow them. And anyway, then we go on to the seventh category, السبب السابع النفاق وهو أن يكون كافرا بقلبه ويظهر للناس أنه مسلم إما بقوله أو بفعله. قال الله تعالى إن المنافقين في درك الأسفل من النار ولن تجد لهم نصيرا. وهذا الصنف أعظم مما قبله، ولذلك كانت عقوبة أصحابه أشد، فهم في درك الأسفل من النار، وذلك لأن كفرهم جامع بين الكفر والخداع والاستهزاء بالله وآياته ورسوله. So then we just mentioned that, we mentioned the ayah. So the seventh category is the hypocrites, hypocrisy. When a person pretends in front of the people that he's with his actions and his statements that he's a Muslim, but while he hides disbelief in his heart. And thus, according to the ayah of Allah, indeed the hypocrites shall be in the lowest depths of the fire, and they will not find a helper for them. Yeah? And the hypocrites and hypocrisy is worse than you know, the other categories mentioned before. This is because the punishment of hypocrisy is the worst punishment. They'll be in the lowest depths of the hellfire because their disbelief combines between disbelief, deceit, and making mockery of Allah and His verses and His messengers. So then the Sheikh mentions the speech of Allah. قال الله تعالى عنهم. Allah said about them, ومن الناس من يقول آمنا بالله وباليوم الآخر وما هم بمؤمنين يخادعون الله والذين آمنوا وما يخدعون إلا أنفسهم وما يشعرون في قلوبهم مرض فزادهم الله مرضا ولهم عذاب أليم بما كانوا يكذبون وإذا قيل لهم لا تفسدوا في الأرض قالوا إنما نحن مصلحون ألا إنهم هم المفسدون ولكن لا يشعرون وإذا قيل لهم آمنوا كما آمن الناس قالوا أنؤمن كما آمن السفهاء ألا إنهم هم السفهاء ولكن لا يعلمون وإذا لقوا الذين آمنوا قالوا آمنا وإذا خلوا إلى شياطينهم قالوا إنا معكم إنما نحن مستهزئون الله يستهزئ بهم ويمدهم في طغيانهم يعمهون. So that's Surah Baqarah was 8:15. So just go over the translation of the meaning. Allah mentioned them and He spoke about them when He said, and of the people there are some who say, we believe in Allah on the last day, while they are not believers at all. They think to deceive Allah and those who believe, but they deceive none but themselves. Only they perceive it not. In their hearts is a disease, so Allah has increased their disease. And for them is a grievous punishment because they lied. And when it is said to them, create not disorder or mischief in the earth, they say, we are only peacemakers. Yeah? Beware, it is surely they who create mischief, but they do not perceive it. And when it is said to them, believe as the people have believed, they say, shall we believe as the foolish ones have believed? Remember, it is surely they that are the fools, but they do not know. And when they meet those who believe, they say, we believe. But when they are alone with the devils, they say, we are with you. We were only mocking. Allah mocks at them and gives them increase in their transgression, wandering blindly. So that is in relation to these hypocrites. And then the Sheikh continues, وَلِلنِّفَاقِ أَلَامَاتٌ كَثِيرَةٌ مِنْهَا أَشَّقُّ فِي مَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ وَإِنْ كَانَ يُظْحِرُ لِلنَّاسِ أَنَّهُ مُؤْمِنٌ قَالَ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ إِنَّمَا يستأذنك الذين لا يؤمنون بالله واليوم الآخر وارتابت قلوبهم فهم في ريبهم يترددون. So here the Sheikh said, and hypocrisy has many signs, and from them is is having doubt in what Allah revealed, even if the person pretends to be a believer in front of the Muslims, in front of the people. Allah the Most High said, only those who will ask leave of you to be exempted, who do not believe in Allah on the last day, and whose hearts are full of doubt, and in their doubt they waver. So they ask leave of partaking in that battle, in the wars. So they were the disbelievers. They were the hypocrites. Yeah. ومنها كراهة حكم الله ورسوله قال الله تعالى ألم تر إلى الذين يزعمون أنهم آمنوا بما أنزل عليك وما أنزل من قبلك يريدون أن يتحاكموا إلى الطاغوت وقد أمروا أن يكفروا به ويريد الشيطان أن يضلهم ضلالا بعيدا وإذا قيل لهم تعالوا إلى ما أنزل الله وإلى الرسول رأيت المنافقين يصدون عنك صدودا. So then the Sheikh, he mentions, and from the signs of hypocrisy is to dislike what Allah and His Messenger have judged with. So Allah the Most High mentions in the following ayah, have you not seen those that they claim that they believe in what has been revealed to you and what has been revealed before you? They desire to seek judgment from the evil one, although from Shaitan, although they were commanded not to obey him, and Shaitan desires to lead them far astray. And when it is said to them, come you to what Allah has sent down and to His Messenger, you see the hypocrites turn away from you with aversion. And then, so that was there. And then the Sheikh said, وَمِنْهَا كَرَاهَةُ ظُهُورِ الْإِسْلَامِ وَإِنْتِصَارِ أَهْلِهِ وَفَرْحُ بِخُذْلَانِهِمْ قَالَ تَعَالَى إِنْ تُصِبْكَ حَسَنَةٌ تَسُوهُمْ وَإِنْ تُصِبْكَ مُصِيبَةٌ يَقُولُوا قد أخذنا أمرنا من قبل ويتولوا وهم فرحون. So the Sheikh mentions, and from the signs of hypocrisy is to dislike seeing the Muslims victorious but being happy at the misfortune and in bad news or defeat. So Allah mentioned, if good befalls you, I mean the Muslims, it grieves you. But these are hypocrites. But if a misfortune befalls you, they say, we had indeed taken our precaution beforehand, and they turn away rejoicing. So you can see that they're not truthful. And then the Sheikh mentioned وَقَالَ تَعَالَى وَإِذَا لَقُوكُمْ قَالُوا آمَنَّا وَإِذَا خَلَوْا عَدُّوا عَلَيْكُمْ الْأَنَامِلَ مِنَ الْغَيْظِ قُلْ مُوتُوا بِغَيْظِكُمْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلِيمٌ بِذَاتِ الصُّدُورِ إِن تَمْسَسْكُمْ حَسَنَةٌ تَسُؤْهُمْ وَإِن تُصِبْكُمْ سَيِّئَةٌ يَفْرَحُوا بِهَا وَإِن تَصْبِرُوا وَتَتَّقُوا لَا يَضُرُّكُمْ كَيْدُهُمْ شَيْئًا إِنَّ اللَّهَ بِمَا يَعْمَلُونَ مُحِيطٌ. So then the Sheikh, he mentions another Quran ayah of Allah the Most High, where he says, behold, you are those who love them, but they love you not. Yeah. So the Muslim who loved them thought they were Muslims, but they love you not. And you believe in the book, all of it. When they meet you, they say, we believe. But when they are alone, they bite their fingertips at you for rage. Say, perish in your rage. Surely Allah has full knowledge of what is hidden in your hearts. If anything from good befalls you, it grieves them. And if anything from evil afflicts you, they rejoice therein. But if you be steadfast and righteous, their plots will not harm you at all. Surely Allah encompasses all that they do. So then the Sheikh, he mentions, وَمِنْهَا طَلَبُ الْفِتْنَةِ بَيْنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ وَتَفْرِيقَ بَيْنَهُمْ وَمَحَبَّةُ ذَلِكَ قال تعالى لو خرجوا فيكم ما زادوكم إلا خبالا ولا أوضعوا خلالكم يبغونكم الفتنة وفيكم سماعون. So the Sheikh mentions from the signs of hypocrisy is also creating trials and tribulations between the Muslims and trying to separate them cause separation between them, and they love that. And the Most High said, had they gone forth with you, meaning in the battle, if they had gone forth with the Muslims in the battles, they would have added to you nothing but trouble, and would have hurried to and fro in your midst, seeking to sow discord amongst you. And there are among you those who would have listened to you as to convey information to them. And Allah is knows well the wrongdoers. So basically, if they came out with you in the battles, they would have caused a lot more trouble and dissension among the ranks of the Muslims. Then the Sheikh, he says, وَمِنْهَا مَحَبَّةُ أَعْدَاءِ الْإِسْلَامِ وَعِمَّةِ الْكُفْرِ وَمَدْهُهُمْ وَنَشْرُ آرَائِهِمْ المخالفة للإسلام. قال تعالى أَلَمْ تَرَ إِلَى الَّذِينَ تَوَلُّوا قَوْمًا غَضِبَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مَا هُمْ مِنْكُمْ وَلَا مِنْهُمْ يَحْلِفُونَ عَلَى الْكَذِبِ وَهُمْ يَعْلَمُونَ. So then the Sheikh, he mentions from the signs of hypocrisy is to show love to the enemies of Islam and the leaders of disbelief, praising them and spreading their opinions, which opposes the teachings of Islam. As Allah the Most High mentioned here, it says, أَلَمْ تَرَ إِلَى الَّذِينَ تَوَلُّوا قَوْمًا غَضِبَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مَا هُمْ مِنْكُمْ وَلَا مِنْهُمْ وَيَحْلِفُونَ عَلَى الْكَذِبِ وَهُمْ يَعْلَمُونَ. The Sheikh, he said, he mentioned Quran ayah. Allah mentions, do you not see those who take for friends a people with whom Allah is angry? They are neither of you nor of them, and they swear to falsehood knowingly. So then, that is aiding the enemies of Islam against Muslims as well. وَمِنْهَا لَمْزَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَأَيُوبُهُمْ فِي إِبَادَتِهِ قَالَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى الَّذِينَ يَلْمِزُونَ الْمُطَوِّعِينَ مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ فِي الصَّدَقَاتِ وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَجِدُونَ إِلَّا جُهْدَهُمْ فَيَسْخَرُونَ مِنْهُمْ سخر الله منهم ولهم عذاب عليم. So then another ayah. So then from the another signs of the hypocrisy is, you know, is to mocking, you know, other Muslims and, you know, how do you say, yeah, so it's mocking the Muslims and, you know, in slandering, in rebuking them and criticizing them. That's what the Sheikh means here, are the believers and defaming them in the acts of worship. Allah the Most High said, these hypocrites are those who find fault with such of the believers as give freely in charity, with such as find nothing to give except the earnings of their toil. So their hard work, they only give, you know, whatever they have of their wealth. So they mock them, they deride them. Allah shall punish them for their mocking and derision, and for them is a grievous punishment. So فيعيبون المجتهدين في العبادة بالرياء ويعيبون العاجزين بالتقصير. So they criticize the believers who strive hard in their worship and accuse them of not being sincere. And they criticize the believers who are unable to strive hard, either due to poverty or sickness, and they accuse them of, you know, being you know, lacking in that regard. So then the Sheikh, he said, وَمِنْهَا ثِقْلَ الصَّلَاةِ وَتَكَاسُلْ عَنْهَا قَالَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى إِنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ يُخَادِعُونَ اللَّهُ وَهُوَ خَادِعُهُمْ وَإِذَا قَامُوا إِلَى الصَّلَاةِ قَامُوا كُسَالَى يُرَاءُونَ النَّاسَ وَلَا يَذْكُرُونَ اللَّهَ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, أثقل الصلاة على المنافقين صلاة العشاء وصلاة الفجر. الحديث متفق عليه. So then the Sheikh, he said, from the signs of the hypocrisy is arrogance towards answering the call of prayer, so from and from yeah, so what do we say here? وَمِنْهَا استِكْبَار. Let me just check, where did we get up to here? Yeah, وَمِنْهَا الْإِسْتِكْبَار أَنَ الدُّعَاءَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ اخْتِكَارٌ وَشَكٌّ. قَالَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى, وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ تَعَالُوا يَسْتَغْفِرُ لَكُمْ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ لَوَّوْا رَؤُوسَهُمْ وَرَأَيْتَهُمْ يَصُدُّونَ وَهُمْ مُسْتَكْبِرُونَ. So here the Sheikh mentioned, so from the sign of hypocrisy is towards answering the call of the believers, due to them belittling and looking down upon them and having doubt in them. Allah said, and when it said to them, come, that the Messenger of Allah shall ask forgiveness for you, they turned their heads aside. And you see them holding back disdainfully while they are big with pride. So then the Sheikh says, وَمِنْهَا ثِقْلُ الصَّلَاةِ وَتَكَاسُلْ عَنْهَا قَالَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى إِنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ يُخَادِعُونَ اللَّهُ وَهُوَ خَادِعُهُمْ وَإِذَا قَامُوا إِلَى الصَّلَاةِ قاموا كسالى يراءون الناس ولا يذكرون لا يذكرون الله الا قليلا. وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, اثقل الصلاه على المنافقين صلاه العشاء وصلاه الفجر. حديث متفق عليه. We read that earlier, so yeah, we skipped that part before. So and from that is that the prayer is heavy for them and they are lazy to establish it. And Allah the Most High, he mentioned mentioned here, the hypocrites seek to deceive Allah, but it is Allah who deceives them for the deception. And when they stand up for prayer, they stand up lazily and to be seen of men, and they don't remember Allah but a little. And the Prophet said in hadith, the most difficult prayer or the heaviest prayer upon the hypocrite the prayer of Isha and the Fajr because of the lateness of the Isha and the earliest of rising of the Fajr. So these people, they can't do that. So, and then the Sheikh, he says, وَمِنْ أَمِنْهَا أَذِيَّةُ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ قَالَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى وَمِنْهُمَ الَّذِينَ يؤذون النبي، وقال تعالى إن الذين يؤذون الله ورسوله لعنهم الله في الدنيا والآخرة وأعد لهم عذابا مهينا، والذين يؤذون المؤمنين والمؤمنات بغير ما اكتسبوا فقد احتملوا بهتانا وإثما مبينا. So from the signs of hypocrisy is to harm Allah and His Messenger and the believers. The Most High mentioned in the first ayah is from among those who annoy the Prophet and say he is all ears, say his giving ear to all ears for your good. He believes in Allah and is true to the faithful, and his mercy for those of you who believe. And those who annoy the Messenger of Allah shall have a grievous punishment. And also the Allah statement, verily those who malign Allah and his Messenger, Allah has cursed them in this world and the hereafter, and has prepared for them an abasing punishment. And those who malign unbelieving men, unbelieving women, for what they have not earned, shall bear the guilt of a calumny and manifest sin. So they were the proofs of that. So فهذه طائفة من علامات المنافقين ذكرناها للتحذير منها وتطهير النفس من سلوكها. So the above mentioned were some of the signs of hypocrisy. We mentioned that in order that we are cautious as not to be, you know, described with any of these characteristics, and so that we purify our souls from them. So then the Sheikh, he mentions a dua. He says, Allahumma a'idhna min al-nifaq وارزقنا تحقيق الإيمان على الوجه الذي يرضيك عنا واغفر لنا ولوالدينا ولجميع المسلمين يا رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وآله وصحبه أجمعين. So the Sheikh mentioned, Allah grant us refuge from hypocrisy and yeah, and give us the ability to actualize true faith in the manner that pleases you, and forgive us and our parents and all the Muslims who are Lord of all creation and all that exists. So may Allah shower the peace and blessings of Allah be upon our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Muhammad and his family and his companions, all of them. And with that, inshallah, we finish. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب عليك. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.